Hello everyone, here is Arthur. Today we will talk about dependency injection. Let's begin. When you have specific problem, it's good first to check if there already exists a way to solve a problem. In informatics, that kind of solution is called design pattern. They illustrate the fact that good practice allows to avoid common errors and problems in programming. A dependent class is what you need for another class. For example, a class that manages the connection with an external API needs a management class with an external connection. We can solve it the ugly way. Copy-paste across multiple classes is hard to maintain. Init a new class inside another is also a bad idea, because you can have multiple copies of the same class at one time and have to send their class dependencies if you want to add any. The solution to this problem is dependency injection. We can initialize a class with business logic. We'll call it service anywhere in the code. The problem begins when we need dependencies. Then every time we call a service, we also need to call all its dependencies. And what if we put an additional object that would take care of adding all dependencies for us? In the dependency injection model, we can create a container that will manage all services. The main role for us is to register services and use this model each time. Imagine a car production line. Four wheels are mounted to each car chassis. Each car is made by an independently operating robot. In the case of changes in standards, if each robot has a programmed logic on how to assemble the wheel, we have to reprogram all of them. However, in the event that cars communicate with an external service that sends the same guidelines for all machines, it would be enough to modify this service, and not all robots. Dependencies and parameters are easily changed and everything works like one living organism. We recommend you stick to the end and watch all our videos in the playlist. Check sources of this video in the description, where you can find more information. Leave the like, comment and subscribe, and share it with friends that want to improve programming skills. Finally, I would like to point out that many frameworks have dependency injection in their offer. There are also a lot of ready-made libraries that provide this solution, so you should consider implementing one of these ready-made solutions. If we want to remain agnostic towards external solutions, we need to prepare the infrastructure for dependency injection ourselves. Thank you for watching, especially for all subscribers, and see you in the next video.